Okay, this video is inspired by He Runs Hundreds. He basically created a session where he used nothing but his mouth in live, and I was kind of inspired by it, so I'm gonna give it a shot myself. So let's see. First things first is I need to get something recorded. I'm using a microphone that has some latency for the screen capture. So it's going to sound double, maybe. So let's do this. Let's see. How about, okay. That sounds like shit. Bam, 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 bam. Let's see how this sounds. Okay, so let's throw this into a sampler. Okay. I'm going to get rid of that attack. I'm going to add some attack to it. And I'm going to take the link down. Turn on loop. It's really difficult to get the the sound to be smooth. Okay, I'm gonna do something different than He Runs Hundreds did. And I'm going to throw in an LFO and map it to something and play around with it. This to reset when I press a key, so I will add in a key. What is it called? I think it's just called like expression control, maybe. Yeah, key track. So I guess I'd want the depth to restart on key track. No, that didn't work. Or maybe my output is not high enough. Maybe I want... Yeah, I think I definitely want depth. I just want to take this down by default, I think. So let's kill it and then change the depth to zero so it's not running. No, I'll turn on depth. What the fuck does that do? Key track. See, it's strange. Maximum. Maybe I need to invert these. I'm pretty sure that should work. Sweet. Right. So, it's not working like I want it to for some reason here. It should be. Like, I want that. I can do it with modulation too if it'll work. I don't know if it's gonna work at all. Yeah, it's like. It does work with mod. Alright, and I would like to have... maybe another LFO. Yeah. Why not? Let's map this to the loop and take the depth way down. And I want something random. Sure what bin is, probably sample and hold. Yeah, that's what it looks like. Not sure. Yeah. Unmap this for a minute, take this back to zero, and then map it again. The depth is too high. So let's change the depth of the mod wheel. It's not high enough. Thank you. set another LFO for the length. Let's move it all the way back and then map it. Some reverb on this thing. Sounds cool. All right, let's add a filter. Slow LFO that's modulating this filter. A really slow one. And I can't put it over here. It would be nice if I could, but so let's map this to the cutoff. Unmap it and change the default frequency. Alright, let's map it again. And I don't know what's happening with this LFO, if it's... with the envelope a little bit on the sample. Actually, thank you. that. Whoops. Sorry, guy. You gotta be muted here. Let's retry that again. Delete. Sound right. There's latency. So I can't play it in real time. But some sounds in there. Let's see. It's clipping, but that's okay for this sound. Sounds okay. The snare is at the end. So let's copy this. All right, let's see. And you have a snare, a kick, a hat, some others. So let's do this. Okay, so this will be our kick. This will be our click, our hat one. Hat two and our snare. So here's our kick. I think the first one was the best. Zoom in a bit. That did not do what I wanted it to do. that. I can't remember if this is the crop or the other thing. Maybe it's this. Sounds pretty good. Okay, there's our kick. I like that one there. This is the one. Yep, good. And then we have the hat. I think it's like down here somewhere. That's open hat, that's hat one. I need something shorter. I guess this will work though. It's actually... That's it. Fine. It's here. Yeah. That's not what I wanted. Stupid. Useless, stupid. Stupid idiot. Sounds pretty good. I should mention the type of mic I'm using is a Zoom H2N, so it's just hooked up right to the computer. So I got the hat. Now here's hat two. It should be down here, I think. If we can turn off that thing. Play when I tell you to play, biatch. Okay, there's hat two. Actually, let's kill the grid. Off with you. Does crop have a shortcut? Oh, that would be sweet. Control and then something else. All right, let's see here. What do we got? Someone's got some feedback probably from my headphones. These aren't closed headphones. And I think down here is the snare. Sounds pretty snare-ish. I have to mess with the envelope of it. Right, so we have kick, click, hat two, and snare. And there's also some more goodies in here somewhere. This. Yeah, this. It's kind of cool, that. That gives you a second snare, but this is the click that I'm after right here. Oh man, I wish it would remember. All right, let's adjust the audio. Kick needs to be louder. That's a little better. Click. Definitely flipped there. That's okay though. All right. Now I want to create my drums. So I will just... grab a drum rack, drop it in, and map my keys here. So I'm going to use an octave higher than I normally, actually two octaves higher than I normally would, because I can't, the mic is over here and I don't want to hit it with my arm. So let's drag our kick to this one and our snare to this one and our hat one to this one and our second hat to this one. And our click to this one. This one. Okay, it sounds like the envelopes need work already. Anyway, let's rename this drums. And let's get to work on some of these. Kick sounds okay. There's like a slight. Funkiness at the end there. And actually, you know what? Instead of using a drum rack, I'm not going to use a sampler. I'm going to use Impulse. Just because there's a little bit more creativity that I can get out pretty fast, and it's already mapped to the keys that I want. Yeah, it sounds a little better by default. Here's our snare. This will be our click. If I can get my mouse over there. And then here's our hat. Our second hat. So you can do some cool things with this. Really easily, like we could take that click and make it almost granular sounding by applying stretch. Interesting, I kind of got the right pitch on that. Pretty decent, I guess. One downside of doing it this way, though, with the impulse, is I can't put effects on each of the pieces of the kit. That's alright, though. I don't need to. I just get the approximation here. cool. Now let's add a beat. So let's mute this guy. In there right now. Not too bad. It's not perfect, but let's add that click in here somewhere. Mouth drum set, I guess. kind of convinced anyway. I think the click is too loud. Solace for a minute. Yeah, it's too loud. Things are happening on the same, just slightly there. Let's just knock them off a bit. Maybe make them a little early instead. Those clicks need to be a little late. Maybe these hats are a tiny bit early. Yeah, let's solo some stuff and let's hear. So let's mute it. I haven't even played that yet. Okay. Sounds all right. This one more time. All right, got it. So let's do a top roll first. Okay. I'm going to turn off monitoring so that I can't hear the latency. I'm going to try and play with this, so. Figure that out. All right, crop this. Actually, not yet. Let's zoom in here and let's quantize this shit. So, right? See that move. Ooh, that sounds cool. Let's not call it top loop, let's call it just whatever loop. Thing about using the MIDI LFOs instead of this shit is that you can actually see them. Word. Let's do that. Audio effects can be inserted into an audio track. Okay. Max audio effect. LFO. LFO. Yeah. Okay, let's map to here. Keep doing that, I could just adjust the offset. It's too fast. In here. D is basically D. This isn't a filter that I'm not even using. As he made it look, that's for sure. I'll turn on that right now. Wow, too loud. Bye. Okay, this is definitely going to use a simpler. Yep. Mm-hmm.
Ba.
Ba. Ba.
Mom. But I'm not Thank you.
Bum 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 bum. video. X Net Rush.